Thank you. क्या क्या जाते हैं इधर में कुछ भी है तो बहुत हो रहा है शॉर्ट टाइम में
हाँ
ना
बहुत ये काल सामने अरेंज कर रहा था गलती होने से तो और भी अच्छा था
सब लेडीज को ज़्यादा है
लेडीज का है तो
लेडीज को मारा नहीं है
नहीं नहीं ये ऑर्गेनाइज करने हो रहा है लेडीज के खेल तो के डब्ल्यू है क्योंकि वुमेंस एसोसिएशन और मार वुमेंस एसोसिएशन
Thank you. 这个不是不是那个那个，我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是那个那个。我这个不是不是 Thank you. And it has been for each and every citizen of India. then I do believe that has been all the same youths has been killed on the 16th of July. So I believe that every justice be given to all, equality amongst all should be provided to all the citizens of India without any discrimination.
Today, I would like to say a few words on the about the incident which took place at Kachar. Actually, we did not blame to this to the state government, but the persons who were involved in the killings of brutally killings of the Chinos and Hills. What they did to them, huh? We feel very pain. They are innocent, and they were brutally killed. And so, the person who are involved in the killings should be given a good punishment. They need to be hanged. Imagine, just imagine, if they were your brothers and sisters, they accused were, how will you feel it? We feel very pain, actually. So, we demand judicial inquiry immediately. And we request that some government to give a big hand, a big help to a bereaved family.
फाइल नहीं करा वर्ड फाइल मार भेज दे तो आओ कहां बचा है
बोलिए बोलिए
आज में जो हम लोग का ये रैली हुआ है ये हम लोग का जो 16 जुलाई को हुआ था हम लोग का ये इंसिडेंट दुर्घटना हुआ था ये बहुत दुख का बात है कि हम लोग का ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया का पालन नहीं हुआ हम लोग का जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है सब इंडिया के जो जनता के लिए है सबके लिए है लेकिन यहाँ पे दिखाई दे रहे हैं कि हम लोग का जो आर्टिकल है आर्टिकल 22(1) और आर्टिकल 22(2) जो में जहाँ में लिखा हुआ है कि जो कानून का जितना रखवाला करना है वो सब पालन नहीं होके जैसा हम लोग का हालत किया था हम लोग का दिनों भाई जो लोग का नाम ही रलबेग कुम्हार ललुम ओम्हार और लरिन सांग वो लोग का तीनों को इतना बुरी तरह से मार दिया कि हम लोग का ह्यूमैनिटी के अगेंस्ट है ये एक मानव जाति के लिए बहुत खतरनाक ये है और हम लोग आशा करते हैं कि ऐसा घटना और नहीं होगी नहीं मिलने से और कैसा होगा और आने दिनों आने वाले समय में हम लोग का कैसा होगा ये सब हम लोग को पता नहीं है लेकिन भी आज में जो घटना हुआ है और दूसरे के ऊपर में भी आ सकता है इसलिए हम लोग विनती करते हैं कि हम लोग का जो सरकार है और न्याय का जो जितना हम लोग का सुप्रीम कोर्ट है जितना हाई कोर्ट है हम लोग को पूरा न्याय हम लोग का सबके लिए देने के लिए हम विनती करते हैं आज में जितना इकट्ठा हुए हैं हम लोग सरकार को विरोध आज से हम लोग विनती करते हैं আমার যুন্তু 16 জুলাই শিলচর ঠায়ত তাতে আমার হেতু ইউথ ভার ইউথ তিনজন আসলে তাতে আমার লালু কইমহার লালবেগ কুমহার আর যশোয়া লরিন সাং तीन जन यू एकदम जो न्याय आमार जो एगेन्स्ट एकदम सरकार एगेन्स्ट आमार ह्यूमेनिटीर एगेन्स्ट होने
सेदान सालंग लंगा इमुन पीलंगा सुंगाबूंग प्रोग्राम मोबलाइज मोबलाइज मोबलाइजा खिन बोल मन लौलेबा खिन किन जो पी हम खेसाजों खेसा मन पोन तुम हेन गेवस्ताने जी चुन इपाथू चम चाखों से हेल लंग चुन वासे की तम वारों का हेल कौन इतबंग हिन भाग चुन दिन हो जब पानी लाखों जिन दियो ही कहा ते मिले कहा में ना केस
नेट नेट बॉल दिंग बॉल लो दिंग से दिंग से को टेन टेन नंबर जी इन किनो टेन तो ना ना हिते सो हैंड डिबेल और हम कोई अवल समझों ते गए मुहात निले टेन तो कता सुजो ले प्रेसिडेंट ले सेक्रेटरी नेपिंग आर हैव रिसीव मांगे छ इला उम जिंग दिंग अन हु फाले वर्ड ऑफ थैंक्स एच डब्ल्यू ए प्रेसिडेंट कमुते ने मीन अ पिक दिंग को इन फॉर मानिंग अट वी वन
जस्टिस
वी वन
जस्टिस
वी वन
जस्टिस
थैंक यू नहीं सुना वी वन
जस्टिस
वी वन
जस्टिस
नुमा लिली
ए मेमोरेंडम सबमिटेड टू श्री हिमंत बिश्व शर्मा ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ असम थ्रू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कमिश्नर ऑफ दिमाहासाउ डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑन द 24 जुलाई 2024 by the Mhar Women Association HWA Assam Hills Region and Kuki Women Association KWA Assam. To Sri Himanta Biswa Sarma, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dispur, Guwahati, Assam, to the Chief District Commissioner, Dimahasau District, Assam. Subject, request for commissioning a special investigation headed by judges of Supreme Court to investigate the extrajudicial actions of Assam police with regards to the death of three youths from Mhar community in Assam. Sir, with the Kuki Women Association KWA and the Mhar Women Association HWA, Assam Hills Region, for submit this memorandum for your kind consideration to initiate an investigation into the extrajudicial killings of three youths in Kachar district of Assam on the 16th of July 2024. The organization would like to draw your attention that there has been a gross violation of human rights, fundamental rights and the constitutional protection guaranteed to the people by a section of the Assam police.
disregarding the rules and procedures established by law, the Assam police has attempted to cover up the extrajudicial killings to protect itself, despite the compelling evidence, which is conclusive of the allegation made against it by the victims' families, that it was a fake and staged encounter. We have, therefore, the constitution of a special investigation team headed by judges of the Supreme Court of India for a detailed investigation to understand the facts of the case as they stand. We are completely shocked by the appalling facts that have come to light during our inquiry, which we would like to bring to your attention. These are the following. Number one, the deceased victims, Lalung Oimhar, 21 years, Lalbek Kumhar, 33 years, Joshua Larinsang, 35 years, are convicted and criminalized by the Assam police without trial as per procedure laid down by law. It is still unclear under which section of the BNS or IPC the deceased were arrested and killed. It is very likely that the deceased were denied their fundamental rights under the Article 22.1 of the Constitution, namely their rights to be informed of the reason for their arrest. The Assam police did not produce the deceased youths before the nearest magistrate within 24 hours, which is a complete violation of the procedures to be followed and laid down for every arrest. Instead, the Assam police kept the deceased youths in police custody till the next day. Number five, the family members, friends and relatives of the deceased have given sworn testimony indicating that they were not informed of their arrest. This failure to notify them of the arrest is a violation of another fundamental right guaranteed under Article 22.2, which provides individuals with the right to inform their loved ones about their arrest and the reasons behind it. Number six, they were denied their fundamental right to consult legal aid of their choice, although it is learned that they had spent the night at the police station. Number seven, the family members of the deceased got the news of their arrest and death from the social media, internet, the news and information which they should have rather received it first from the police. Number eight, a video that has resurfaced on the internet depicts the deceased individual cooperating with the police and showing no signs of resistance during the arrest. This portrayal suggests that at the time of the incident, the individual did not pose a threat to peace, public order, or society as a whole. As a result, it calls into question the justification for the use of force by the police in this situation. Without evidence of aggression or violence towards the officers, the notion of the police defending themselves in this encounter seems unfounded. Number nine, another video taken after the arrest depicts the deceased individuals kneeling on the ground, blindfolded with their hands tied behind their backs, being harassed by police officers. This disturbing footage showcases the vulnerable position in which the deceased men were placed as they face potential threats to their very lives by such egregious abuses of power by the police. Number 10, the clothes worn by the deceased men during their arrest and after their death are not the same. Number 11, aside from the violations of the above mentioned fundamental rights and protection given by the law to the suspects, it is evident that the deceased youths were denied the right to equality under Article 14 of the Constitution. They were denied the right to avail the protection and benefits other suspects enjoy, and they were denied the right to fair trial guaranteed to them by the Constitution under Article 21. Thus, it is evidently clear that the Assam police lied regarding the cause of death of the victims, which we believe they did so to evade any further investigation that could expose the heinous crimes that had committed. The suspects succumbed to death while they were under the custody of police as a result of their errors and at a place outside the police station, with a video existing as proof wherein, in the said video, the suspects were seen being blindfolded, hands tied, and forced to kneel down, surrounded by aggressive police personnel. However, contradictory to the video evidence, the police notice said they died during a cross-fire exchange between militants and the police. Producing the suspects before the magistrate should have been the priority, and protection of the suspects under their arrest is their duty, rather than exposing the suspect to a dangerous environment, even if we gave them the benefit of doubt on the existence of more militant groups in the area where the suspects succumbed to death. However, they, on the pretext of further investigation of the case, which could have been done later and without the involvement of the suspects, caused the death of the suspects. Sir, it is therefore justified to conclude that the suspects lost their lives due to extrajudicial killings by the Assam police, organizing a fake encounter with the Supreme Court, which the Supreme Court observed and equated to cold-blooded murder in its judgment on Prakash Kadam versus Ramprasad Viswanath Gupta case in 2011. The above findings lead to the conclusion that there were widespread violations of fundamental rights and human rights guaranteed under the constitutions against the arrested suspects since the arrest and even after their death. In this case, the Assam police violated the supremacy of the constitution and the rule of law. If adequate measures are not taken that could deter other police forces in the country, it will serve as a green light for the other unethical police forces to misuse their power and authority. Unethical police personnel like them pose a threat to democracy, the constitution, and the citizens. Therefore, protecting citizens from unethical activities and abuse of power is a necessity for a constitutional democracy like ours. Since the cause of their death is being recorded by the police as death succumbed during a cross counter firing, it becomes increasingly challenging for any investigation agency to delve deeper into the matter. Despite the overwhelming evidence against the police readily available on the internet, the blatant violations of the suspects' human and fundamental rights remain unchecked from the moment of their arrest to their untimely demise. As such, the only viable solution to ensure justice for the victims and their grieving families is the establishment of a special investigation team led by a judge or judges from the esteemed Supreme Court. This approach will guarantee a thorough and impartial examination of the events leading to the tragic loss of life and timely delivering the justice that is rightly deserved. An impartial investigation headed by judges of the Supreme Court is an absolute necessity in order to maintain integrity and credibility in the process. The potential risk of threats or bribes influencing the outcomes of the investigation are significantly lower when conducted by a commission under the guidance of the highest judicial authority in the country. Such a commission would serve as a powerful deterrent against corrupt practices within the police fraternity, preventing them from wielding unchecked power over the lives of citizens. It is crucial to uphold the principles of justice and fairness by establishing a special investigation team commission led by Supreme Court judges to ensure accountability and transparency in the process. Lastly, the justice for the victims, particularly in this case, and the fate of many others who can become victims depends upon our decision today. Believing in our wisdom and your empathy for the vulnerable sections, including the scheduled tribes of India, we are confident of a positive response from your office. With warmest regards, sincerely yours, Nehemi Tolor, President HWA Assam Hills Region, Laring Nehem Pulamte, General Secretary HWA Assam Hills Region, Helen Singh Soon, President KWA Assam, Chongbak Len Thang, Secretary KWA Assam. Copy for kind information to Chairperson, National Human Rights Commission of India, the Chief Secretary, Government of Assam, the Director General of Police, DGP Assam, the Secretary, Home and Political Government of Assam, the District Commissioner, Timahasau District Assam, the District Commissioner, Kachar District Assam, got file.
Kipatu, avet avelin kahin po.
Anything else I can do, madam?
Sir, हम लोग
का तरफ से एक रिक्वेस्ट है ना, प्लीज लुक इन टू द मैटर ना. एक बार मुझे दीजिए, मैं अभी पढ़ लेता. दे आर ऑल द सेम, सब सब एक ही है.
Sir, one copy to for the Chief Minister, one is for you, and these are the copies. You please for what this for me. From your office. Yeah, yeah.
This you have to submit it yourself. Okay. Because see, you have addressed it to Honorable Chief Minister, na? This copy will go through us, through the District Commission. The remaining ones, na? This you will be sending it yourself.
Thank you, sir.
situation ni kurang tempo localizing kita on saying get to a president from we need to chance ni hatet sama lang aman jong teng le bon ba nai to mun lang lang age thora
तो जाने वक्त आप लोग सावधानी से जाना है, क्योंकि ये दो दिन हम नोटिस कर रहे हैं कल भी शायद एक फैमिली का 6 आदमी एक्सीडेंट में मर गया, एक फैमिली का सारा फैमिली खत्म हो गया। अभी बढ़िया से हो गया प्रोग्राम, तो जाने के वक्त आप लोग जो ड्राइवर वगैरह है ना उसको थोड़ा जानबूझकर गाड़ी चलाना बोलना होगा, बोले धीरे धीरे चलाओ हम घर जाएंगे अभी तो, और डिस्पैच के समय डिसिप्लिन मेंटेन करना होगा, यही कहना है मेरे को। सबको धन्यवाद, हिमाचल पुलिस की तरफ से।